As you know, this is my scooter. I did that a few months ago.
This is the M365 wheel, which was on the front, now it's on the back. That'd be the front, there's the back. So, I've now got to fit the cover that allows me to put a brake disc on.
I've never ridden it. I've just tested it basically inside, firing the wheel up. That's it. Now, I found out, because I got this adapter plate allows you to put the disc on the hub when you fit a rear wheel drive. There's actually a piece, which is a nut, that you put on the Schrader valve. That allows the Schrader valve to move outwards to clear the rear arm. Now what I had to do was, I had to take the one off the front and put it on the back because the valve was shorter and it was catching. I found out from, what's his name? I found out from the bloke who actually makes them that there is actually a nut that you're supposed to put on there. Now obviously I have got the inner tube off the front on the back and the back on the front. I've got two new inner tubes. I seem to remember pinching the one on the front, I think it was, and I had to repair it, and I don't like that, so I bought two brand spanking new ones, so I've got to change the tubes. Now, whether I'm ever going to be able to test this thing, I don't know.
As you've seen, or as you're going to see, this isn't as straightforward to actually change the tube if you put one of these hubs on it, or disc adapters, because I have to take... There's a little retainer in there that I have to take out. Obviously I can't get to it, so this has got to come off. On this one I've sealed it. So I don't know how, whether it's just gonna pop out or what. I might have to give it a good whack on the floor, I think. What I had to do, put the nut on the other side to protect the threads, whack it down as hard as I can on the floor, and it pops it out. Now this, as I said, I already sealed it. I put ferrofluid in here, obviously to cool it down, so I've got to clean all this up now. And as you can see, there isn't a lot of ferrofluid that's actually come out because I haven't ridden it. Literally, I have not ridden it. The only bit that there is that bit, which is where I spun the wheel up just to test it. Anyway, I can now get at the all important retainer thing. When I can get the damn thing out. This keeps the valve in the right position. And it's a terrible, terrible design. Well, I thought that I'd come up with something better than this. Like that. So now I can take... That's going to have to hang. But now, I can take the tyre off. After I've let a bit more air out. When you're taking tyres off, what you've got to do is you've got to push... If you pinch that in like that... I've shown you this before, I know. Obviously use proper tyre levers. I'm a professional idiot, so I know what I'm doing. And what you'll notice is, as you're pushing that in, as you're squeezing it, the tyre moves. See, it goes into the... There's a recess that the tyre actually goes into. You want to pull the tyre into that recess. And the only way you do it is squeeze it flat. Like that. And then you get your lever. I've got to be careful because otherwise it damages the pristine wheel. And when you fit in the tyre, ultimately you do the same thing. Yes, these are 10-inch tyres and they're a hell of a lot better than the 8-inch. The 8-inch ones are terrible. Just remember the direction of rotation when you take this off, because otherwise it's not going to be very easy to get it back on, and then get it back off, and then get it back on again when you have to change the direction. And don't ask me how I know. Right, so I'm going to get it on the other side somehow. Make sure I don't pinch the inner tube. But then again, it doesn't really matter on this one, does it? And then you do that. And then the tube comes straight out. Now, I don't need to take the tire off itself. I risk putting it on backwards, so I'm not taking it off. Let's make that wide. All I need to do is change the inner tube, which this one is... Oh, this is the good one. When you're putting tubes in, don't put them in like that. I bought this specifically for assembling tyres, believe it or not, for no other reason. Anyway, get your tyre inflator. Doesn't matter what PSI you pump it up to. Well, yes it does. Don't pump it up too high. Pump it up a bit. Like that, just so as it takes shape. You get your talcum powder, put some on, and then wipe the excess off, because you don't want it going bloody everywhere. This is just to take the stickiness away, and it eases assembly massively. It makes it a lot easier. So you get rid of the excess. You put it in the tyre first, and it forms to the outside of the tyre then, and it keeps everything away from where you're actually levering. And then you put your valve in. If I remember rightly, it's a good idea to put the retainer in first before you actually assemble it, purely because it's a nightmare to get it in otherwise. So you're left with that. Now, what you've got to do then is push the tyre into the bead, into the centre bead, without pinching the tube, like that. So you can see that's gone in the centre there. Then you go from the opposite side of the valve. Basically what you do again is you push that into the bead like that, so as it doesn't pinch anything. And then you can push this side over. As some people say, you start at the valve. I've never have started at the valve. Now, when you get so far that it will retain itself like that, keep the pressure on this side, because you need all of that to go into the recess again. Because as soon as it goes into the recess, it relieves the pressure on the other side, and it makes it a lot easier. When you put the tyre on, what I generally do is get some more talc. Try not to get it absolutely everywhere. Literally just rub it in around the bead, and it helps it seal back on. Because like I say, the 8-inch ones are rather tight. Right, the next thing I do is you get it to about between 10 and 15 psi, and you see on this side where it's actually sitting outwards, give it a helping over the other side, just pull it over a bit, just to make sure it seats in the middle, because otherwise I have had on the older ones, the 8-inch ones, it's only seated on one side, so that was the only way I could do it. Now, because this has got such a short valve stem, I'm not going to need to put the spacer in. The spacer is basically a nut, I think you put it on the underside. I don't know which side you put it. I don't need it. Don't care. I've cleaned it all off. I used some acetone just to get the remainder of the glue off. Now, the glue that I use is E6000. It seals, it dries like a rubber, so it's still flexible and it seals perfectly. The only place that you want to put glue, if you use any glue or sealant of any kind, is literally on the outside. Don't put it on this anywhere near this edge here. You just literally want it on the outside there, not on the inside, because otherwise it goes in there. So what I've got to do now is put this back on. So put that on there, rock it. Just to knock it down a bit. Let it bite on one side, give it a tap on the other side, and it should pull it down. Oh, incidentally, if anyone's watching this and they've seen my the torch review videos that I keep doing, I haven't sold out, and I'm quite offended about the people who said that I have sold out. I'm literally doing those as a it's not really a stopgap. Those are just to give you more content, because otherwise you wouldn't get any at all, and people say I want content, so I'll give you bloody content, and all they do is moan. Well, I've got a message for you. If you don't like the title, don't watch the video. After you've done that, go around the centre where the bearing is and give it a few taps with something. That's literally to get the bearing to seat properly, or to get the outer race to seat on the inside. And that's done. When I came to fit the disc, it's hard to explain, but I couldn't get the disc in the right place. Like that. So what I had to do, I think these are 1mm washers, are they? 1mm washers. I had to put 1mm washers behind. I don't think I could get a spacer at the time. Anyway, that's what I used, just 1mm washers. So I've got to put those back on. I've torqued these up to a thumb, that much. Obviously you've got to make sure that the disc is in the same rotation as the tyre, and the tyre also, you've got to bear in mind which way the wheel goes. Yes, you have to work it all out. Don't put the tyre on and then think about putting it on. Put this on, match it up, draw a line on here which rotor with what the rotation is, and then fit the tyre on and then fit the disc on, because otherwise when you come to fit it, you'll find that it's wrong. Anyway, as you can now see, there is no valve stem sticking out of there, so that's going to be perfect. And I can no longer get that on. Oh dear. Oh well, there's enough pressure in there anyway. Doesn't matter. Right, I'm going to go and fit it. Just one word of warning when you're fitting this. Make sure you fit this spacer on first before you put the wheel in, and then you put the two screws in the slots, because otherwise you ain't going to get it in. I had to file inside of there because the bolts on the disc were catching. When I took this apart, you might notice that there was marks around the hub. That was purely because I had to get a screwdriver in the disc and bend the disc in places, because these discs are bloody terrible. This was warped terribly. But now that's all fitted. So all I need to do is put the phase wires back in and the Hall Sense wires, which are these, and the job's a good one. This is the mono rim suspension. It blows the socks off the cheap Chinese one. It's actually shock absorbed. It's not just a spring, as far as I can figure out. I don't know actually, but it does work a hell of a lot better. It's a lot smoother, it's a lot softer, and it makes the ride fantastic. So if you know what's good for you, save your pennies up and buy a monorim rather than the cheap Chinese one. They're a lot thicker as well. A lot more sturdy. Hell of a lot more sturdy. And they're not that much heavier.